see the tears in my eyes, you hear this instrumental. Jesus was instrumental in blessing my mental. Every time I drove a car, could have twisted the metal.
That was literally like 10 cops in a row driving past. And that's not the first time we've seen that just now. We're on the run, heading to Ventura because we started smelling smoke in West Hollywood too.
Bro, we can't be nowhere. Look, we have the whole car packed with basically our life.
It's all like dusted.
Hopefully now when we get to Ventura, we can chill there and be there and stay there. But while being on the road, we have a CS semifinal in like 5 minutes. We're trying to watch that too. You know what I'm saying?
We're trying to.
FaZe versus Liquid, IEM Chicago. Trying to get it up here, but it's so, driving like this, days like this, when there's a fire like this, the service is so bad. Like normally it's bad here. Normally it's bad here, now it's even worse.
The fire happened at the house. I had, absolutely. Yeah. There's more cops. That's one. He's late. This guy forgot.
Here we go. Another guy.
Dude, there's so many cops.
Bro, so many cops.
How fucking sick is that, bro? Ever since I was a little kid, this is the only beach I've seen in Chicago.
Quite knew how to use this camera, but I'm not sure.
What do you mean?
All right, guys, we're going into the eye of the fire right now. I'm completely ready, as you can see. Ready to take on this fire and save Kim Kardashian single-handedly. Actually, I got you, yo. So it's not single-handedly.
I get to help.
But yo, I will fight the fire, bro.
Oh, we're down. We're prepared.
But no, we had a homie, shout out to our homie Levi for hooking it up for us. He's been taking care of us while this fire's been going on. I'm sure you guys have already seen that throughout the vlog from Teeqo and shit. But I just want to thank him again. But now we are leaving where he's letting us stay at, and we're going back to Calabasas, back to the house, to see if our house is burned down. So I will have the reveal if our house is burnt or not.
It's like an unboxing.
Yeah, it's like a house unboxing, you know what I'm saying? But we just need to know if it's on fire or not.
Yeah.
If it's not on fire, I get my Tesla because I left Elon there. Sorry, bro. I gotta save him. Gotta save the Gucci jacket, the clout goggles, Vape Lord Nord's robe. Should I even take his vape, bro?
I gotta save
his vape, bro.
We gotta vape out the house.
Oh, right? Man. And then I'm gonna get Teeqo some underwear or something. Gonna be there soon. We'll catch you guys later. I'm gonna save the world. Pasado, yo.
What the hell? Bro, our communits is a little bit burnt, as you can see. A little crispy. It's okay.
We got green grass.
It's actually not okay. But here it looks beautiful. Like nothing ever happened. Hey!
Damn, no visitors allowed right now.
You know what I'm saying? Let's talk to the gate real quick.
We just need to grab some stuff from the house.
Where do you live?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
So, the fire legit is in our, like, right at the community, but the
bro,
fence...
Bro, do you see that? This is our community, bro.
Burn. The fence protected it, guys.
The fucking metal fence. What's it made out of, bro? Metal. Good metal. And I'm saying, 10 each.
But the fire is legit there at the houses. Oh my god.
To go, I swear I might accidentally break this off, by the way. Because I'm trying to like figure out how to stop it.
So. Whoa.
Ooh, it's right next door. This is right next to our house, bro. Burn. Yeah, stay away, bitch. Stay away from us. Tia! But honestly, it's beautiful on this side, you know what I'm saying? It's just a little
bit. It's just everything outside of our landscape is.
It's like the perfect turkey bacon piece. A little bit burnt, crisp.
Well, he had his Ferrari out, man. That was beautiful.
You left his Ferrari out? Oh, man, I left the Tessie out.
Tessa.
All right, here's the house reveal.
It made it past the gate right there.
Bro, we're about to get the house unveil.
House unveil.
Whether we lost our shit or not.
No way, we could have lost our.
Okay, if every other fucking house is okay, and then ours isn't, this is about to be not bueno.
Not bueno.
OK. Okay, ready? Is there a Tesla?
Where's the Tesla?
Oh. Yo! What's up?
Oh, the branch. What the hell, branch?
I didn't even consider the fact that a tree could have fucking fell on my baby. Dude, you're looking cleaner than I left you. What's good, mamacita? Okay. That's awesome. All right, Teeqo, we're chilling. What's up, chow?
What's up? My hair's probably looking crazy, but you know, it happens when we don't have a house.
We don't have a house. We're chill. What is this game you're playing?
Bro, I don't even know the name.
If I've understood it right, you're basically painting the map, shooting paint at each other, I guess. But yo, we're still on the run. And what you guys just saw was basically a little vlog put together from the days that we have not been home. So it was a little bit of changing places and getting to this place where we're right now. By the way, shout out Levi. Once again, you heard Nordan say it earlier. I've said earlier in this vlog to shout out Levi. If it wasn't for him, we would have probably been stranded or just like living on top of each other. So like, we're super thankful and super blessed to have a friend like Levi at our lives right now, especially because of a situation like this. And he was fortunate enough to have a beach house where we are right now. And what was the latest news about Calabasas? There's another fire now, apparently. By the way, this is Tuesday, as of today, when the video is going live, I'm recording this. There is another fire now. There is still toxics in the air, so they don't really want to let people back in. And my theory as well is, since they have evacuated everything, they're not going to start letting people back in to Calabasas or in the area, period, till they're 100% sure that there's not going to be another fire. Because till then, it's easier for them to have people outside than having people come in and possibly having to leave again. So I feel like it's going to be a couple more days till we're gonna be able to go back, because right now too, I think later today or tomorrow you might be allowed back, but there's not gonna be a point because no power, no service, no internet, no water, no nothing. So till then, there's not gonna be a point to really go back. But we've been super blessed to be in a fantastic beach house.
So
place to stay, place to sleep, awesome couch, internet. A beach once again, which we've been on. Sky has been loving it. He was a little bit stressed the first couple of days. A lot of you guys have been asking about Sky. Obviously, Sky's been fine. We made sure he's been with us the whole time, of course. But he was a little bit stressed the first day, as expected. He didn't really want to eat too much the first day. He didn't really pee. He didn't really shit. But now he's chilling. We took him to the beach. If you guys follow me on IG, you probably saw that. Again, if you haven't followed me on IG, told you guys to do so you can see updates of us chilling and vibing here. Ciao. What was the house like when you came back? Like,
we were driving back, we weren't able to get off the exit to our house. We had to go down like 5 exits down. We had to pass like for like 10 minutes our exit.
Like, all the roads are open.
Yeah, all the roads were blocked off by cops and stuff like that. And then once we got off the exit, we had to go take the back road. And once we got onto our, like, the road that gets to our house, it was completely, like, torched. You see the trees and everything burnt up.
Yeah, I saw a little bit about that. You guys have probably seen a little bit about that, too, in this vlog that Nordan recorded whenever they went back. And, like, the mountain, like, walls are just burnt. But, like, just black and burnt.
Seeing, like, those white plastic fences, like, or whatever. Yeah, I think they're plastic fences.
Yeah.
On the street, those are, like, melted, like, completely burnt. You can see it going into. But when we got to our community, it was perfect. It was awesome. Like, the firefighters and the first responders killed it. I mean, they protected it practically everything. I mean, you could see it got into a little bit of the community. You could see, like, they're trying to clean it up. But we got lucky.
We got really lucky, man. I just now saw the footage of them going back when I started editing this video. And I saw Nordan recording inside of the community. And it was really close, bro. The mountain walls.
Right next to our house.
Again, people have lost their homes, people lost their houses, and people are not even fortunate enough to have a friend that has a house or place like this that he can stay in. So we're super fortunate to have a place to go back to in hopefully a couple of days, and to have been fortunate enough to be staying at a place like this and having each other not be, you know what I'm saying? It could have been so much worse.
We didn't have Levi, I don't know where we would have gone.
Bro, I don't know where we would have gone either. And now we got beautiful, man. Like, this beach view, we really, really got lucky. But I just wanted to give you guys an update real quick. I hope you guys, as bad as it sounds, enjoy this vlog and give you guys somewhat of an update. And again, we are very, very cool and good and comfortable and safe. And we will hopefully be back in Calabasas in a couple of days. I'm going to try and keep you guys updated on social media or in other videos or vlogs. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Peace out.